In this video, we will teach you about Blender 2.80 Beta Version's user interface. And this is the workflow of this video. Blender 2.80 version is still developing and it doesn't have a manual. Therefore, in this lesson, we compare old and new versions of Blender's interfaces. For that, we separate Blender's interface into few parts. They are Info Bar, Header Bar, Tool Shelf, Operator Panel, 3D Viewport, Outliner, Properties Panel, Properties Region Panel, and Timeline. First, look at the old version of Blender's Info Bar. The new version of Blender separated this Info Bar into two parts. It separates this part of the informations into down of the bar, and added some of the mouse controls information into it. And Info Bar's screen layout drop-down is changed as tabs, like this, and new layouts added into it. Now, look at the header bar. The old version's header is at the bottom area, and is splittable. The new version's header moves into the top of the viewport, and it unsplittable. And this header is turned into the part of the 3D viewport. Now, look at the tool shelf. The old version has like this tool shelf, and new version's tool shelf turns into like this, and it has differences with oldest one. Now, look at the operator panel. You can see the difference. Its placement slightly turns into the 3D viewport, and no other features changes. Now go to the 3D viewport. The new version's 3D viewport has some special features. You can see these features, and it makes your viewport control easy, and you can also control your viewport using mouse only. Now go to the outliner. The new version's outliner contains few features. The new version of Blender doesn't use screen layers, and it uses collections for that. If you open your old version's projects using the new version of Blender, then the new version of Blender converts its all layers into collections. Now see outliner's items controlling special icons. You know that old version of Blender only has restrict viewport visibility, viewport selection, and rendering special icon for its outliner. The new version's outliner has disable icon with these icons. Now go and see how our properties panel is. The new version's properties panel's theme changed, and it has new tabs. In this version, activated tools and workspace control setting are contained in this new active tools and workspace setting tab. And properties panel has a new output tab. This tab is came from the old version of Blender's render tab. The old version's render tab's dimensions, output, metadata, and post-processing options are separated into the output tab. And this stereo's copy option came from the old version of Blender's render layer tab. Now finally look at the timeline and properties region panel. They don't have any much differences. Only timeline's theme, flow and have some extra options. Now we have done the user interface part. If you like this video, hit like button. If you have learned something new, hit subscribe. If you hit the bell icon, you will get notifications as soon as we upload a new video. Learn with IBN. Thank you for watching.